Yeah, hi.
This is Jaime again, and today I want to show you how you can make it pescado a lo macho. It's a Peruvian saute fish with a hot seafood sauce. And this time I want to use, again, tilapia, like I do for my ceviche. So I want to do tilapia, I want to put a little salt and pepper and a little cumin. I want to do a little bit of seafood. I have in here like a Manila clams, shrimp, and baby octopus. I have onions and tomatoes, garlic, a little bit of chile amarillo, that's the chile from Peru, a little bit of beer. So this dish is more like the north of Peru, and we want the north coast of Peru. Milk, you can use cream, you can use evaporated milk, panca paste, or like I said before, you can substitute with California pot dry chilies. You can make your own pasta. I want to use the same ají that I used today for the ceviche too. So anyway, and cilantro and green onions are for the decoration in the end when we already finished the dish. So in this case, we want to put a little bit of olive oil to fry the fish first. So after that, we're going to incorporate it all the ingredients in there. We're going to pull out the fish from the pan, keep it separate for a little bit, and after that we're going to saute the onions, tomatoes, garlic, the panca, the beer, and make the sauce with a little bit of milk in there, and the seafood in there. So lo que voy a hacer en estos momentos, le dije en inglés, pero lo voy a decir en español, estoy haciendo un pescado a lo macho, y para esto necesito tengo un filete de pescado, cebolla, tomates, ajo, tengo conchas, camarones y pulpitos. Y también tengo la cerveza y tengo el ají panca, pero en este caso no le voy a echar ají, voy a sustituir el ají panca por el Anaheim, California pot chili, dry chili. So, like I explained to you in other videos, you know, you can cook it very simple. You can deseed it, take it out the seeds, boil it in water, blend it, and you have your own paste. So you can use it for anything, you know, for any occasions. And also, I'm going to substitute the rocoto, the Peruvian chili, for regular ají, you know, like I blended chile serrano and jalapenos and a little bit of olive oil, you know, to make it spicy in there, you know what I mean? So the seeds of the chiles is good, so it's spicy. So I don't think that's going to be so much different in there, the flavor. So en vez de rocoto, lo que voy a usar hoy día va a ser ají mexicano, que se llama serrano, y también voy a usar el ají jalapeño. So en estos momentos estoy cocinando el pescado. What I'm going to do, I'm going to sear it and brown it. So after that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to voy a sacarlo de la sartén y lo voy a poner aparte, y de ahí voy a cocinar la cebolla con el tomate y con los mariscos. Voy a agregar la cerveza, que se reduzca, y después agregar la crema o la leche. So lo que estoy friendo in this moment right now, I'm saute the fish. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to flip it up. You know, some chefs are using flour to not stick in the pan. Why not use flour? You know, I mean, what I'm using is, you know, heat it at the pan very, very hot. And after that, what I do is fry the first part of the fish. And after that, the second part. You know, see how brown it is? So the fish is already almost cooked. So what I'm going to do, I want to saute a little bit more, cook it a little bit more longer, you know, like maybe 2-3 more minutes. Take it off from the pan to the plate. And I start to make my sauce. So now the fish is almost done. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take it out from the pan and see how is it. So you have a lot of things. So in the same pan, I want to add a little more olive oil. So lo que hice fue sacar el pescado casi mitad cocinado, no tan cocinado, para que ya al último lo pongamos en la salsa y se cocine con la salsa, que se termine de cocinar con la salsa. So what I do is I pull it out the fish. So it's almost half a way to cook, because the rest of the fish is going to be cooked in the sauce. But right now I'm going to add it. The onions and tomatoes. Garlic. And aquí amarillo, the yellow chili from Peru. So we're going to make like it saute a little bit. A little bit of salt. A little bit of pepper. Maybe you can put a little more cumin in there. Yeah, I like cumin. Like all Peruvians, they like cumin. So we're going to do this. We're going to saute. So the flavor that was in the pan when you cook the fish is going to incorporate to the meat, to the onions and the tomatoes and the garlic. And to make the own sauce, you know what I mean? And after that, when we add the seafood, also is going to lose the flavor to the sauce. So, so this is the moment when we're going to add 1 spoon of aji panca. You know, it's a little bit spicy. Aji panca is very good. So 1 spoon of aji panca. We saute a little more. And we add the seafood. So we eat the seafood. Salt in the seafood, you know. So we want to cover for a little bit so they can, the shells can be open. The clams. So lo que hice ahorita fue satear. So now, the seafood, the shells that are almost open, but the rest of the seafood is almost cooked. So that was when we start to add the fish again. Make a little hole in here, so we can add the fish. So you have to be careful to not overcook the seafood. If you overcook the seafood, it's not good, you know, it's like a chewing. So now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sweat it a little more. See, when they call pescado a lo macho, so we're going to cover and sweat it a little bit. And in the meanwhile, I'm going to add the beer too, so the beer can evaporate the alcohol and give it the flavor of the dish. So lo que estoy haciendo ahorita, ya incorporé el pescado, ahí está el pescado, ya el seafood, los mariscos están que se abren, están que se cocinan. So en estos momentos lo que voy a hacer es incorporar la cerveza. So este plato, ya saben, como peruanos que son, este plato es norteño casi, ¿no? Porque tiene cerveza. Alguna vez se le echan vino. So what I'm going to do right now, I incorporate the beer in here. And we're going to boil it so the alcohol can evaporate. And the flavor of the beer is going to be there, you know what I mean? They're going to be absorbed by the seafood, the fish and everything. So now, you can see that the shells are already open. So that was when I'm going to incorporate the milk and this hot sauce. So people use, you know, cream. In this case, I'm going to use milk. Sorry. Yeah. So anyway, so the shells are already open. I'm going to add the hot sauce. Like I say, guys, in this case, I don't have rocoto. Because you gotta use rocoto. You know, rocoto is a chili from Peru. You can find in any Mexican store. So now, the dish is done. You know, we're waiting for the shells to finish open. And we have a pescado a lo macho. So the fish is done, the sauce is done, the pescado a lo macho is done. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you a little more flavor in there. I'm going to put a little bit of green onions in there and a little bit of cilantro. Mix it up and that's it. So el pescado macho ya está listo. Tomó solamente 8 minutos en que se haga toda la comida. Ahorita ya está todo preparado. Le acabo de echar un poquito de cebollita verde y le acabo de echar también culantro. So, So the fish is already, the sauce is already. So I want to show you how you can serve this very good, delicious pescado a lo macho. You can make it in 5-10 minutes, you know, because fish, seafood cook very fast. So this is the piece of fish in here. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to put one shell in here. One more shell in here, around here maybe. See the aji amarillo, how they can cook. Maybe a couple shrimps in the top. Baby octopus. And you have pescado a lo macho. A little bit of sauce in there. One more shrimp. And you saw the pescado a lo macho. So anyway, guys, you know, I hope you enjoy this food. And I hope you learn something good and something very simple and very easy for to eat it at home. Very healthy, very easy. So lo que hice, serví todo el pescado, serví la salsa con el pescado. Está un poquito amontonado, pero ahí está el pescado abajo, está la salsa con los camarones. Y espero que les haya gustado y los veo la próxima con otra nueva receta. So I see you again, guys, with a new recipe. So enjoy your food, be safe, you know, be home. Take care, guys. Bye bye.